back to the channel. Thanks for tuning in. Today, we're painting another rifle. This time it's going to be my buddy's CVA Scout and 450 Bushmaster. He bought a brand new last year, got a little bit of rust on it, so I decided to take it down and not totally strip it, but there's get the pitting away. And now I have it disassembled, and I'm going to take each piece individually and do a base coat on them, then reassemble the gun. I don't want to miss any nooks and crannies. I want the paint job to be as tight as I can make it. So let's get to it. All right, so as you can see, we got our barrel dangling. Somebody on my last video with the AR camo job suggested I hang this time instead of set everything down. And I never really got any flat spots because of it last time, but yeah, I just got her on a wire hanger, and it'll be okay. And I got her plugged up, and then I also have it taped along the scope rail mount screw holes. So let's get after it with some dark forest green. I think it's going to be a really good color for the base coat. Didn't really feel like black. And I don't know if I even have any matte black, so let's give her a rip. Potato chip. Yeah, this hanging thing's pretty good. Make sure we get a nice, even coat. It's hard to tell if you get an even coat on that side because there's not a lot of light, but I guess what's cool about hanging it is I get to rotate it into spots that I can't step into, so see if we can, we'll just flip it actually. Well, here, let me get the scope rail mount piece up here first so I can see that's done. Now this is a base coat, so it doesn't have to be totally thick and runny, and I don't want it to be. Not taping off any logos here for my friends on the Facebook page. They know who they are. Let's see if I can get some of that. Yep, that's gonna drip, but that's okay. That's gonna be fine. It's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay. Because there's going to be more to come. Shouldn't have did that. Novice. Rookie mistake. This bottom lug will not be truly visible, so I'm not so much worried about that. Much as I am getting a nice base coat to create some rust protection. So this thing don't rust on us again. Because my buddy just washes her, gets her wet, and puts her away like that. So, which is alright. Sometimes you gotta be like that. Shout out 511. Okay, it ain't gonna run, but it'll be good enough for a base coat for sure. And, oh, nope, missed some. Probably jacking up my camera lens. Oh well. Base coat, it'll all be fine. We'll let her hang, and then we're on to the next piece. Cool. We're clear of paint from our screw mount, or scope mount screws. That's all. Doesn't need to be neat, because scope mount's going right over that, so. Alright, so while we're letting this dry, we'll kind of go through our color selection real quick. This is drying a little bit more. I already kind of put a print on it, but guess what? It's the base coat, so I don't give a fuck. We have our Earth Brown, one of my favorites. This is a new one. This is a Down to Earth from Rust-Oleum. I didn't shake it up enough or whatever. I'm happy with the color compared to the Rust-Oleum Camo Tan, but of course I probably didn't mix it up enough. I was just trying to shoot it up quick. But that's the Down to Earth. One of the newest ones I introduced, this. I'm not sure how much of this I'm going to use. This is Eden. This is the Ultra Color, Ultra Cover Satin. And to my surprise, it's not really that satin. So a light touch of that could kind of be a little bit more matty. The summer wheat was very matte, but it pops quite a bit. That's down here in this corner, right here. This is the Krylon Cover Max. So that's an ultra matte type. Then you have what our base coat is. That's right here. Kind of tried to see how that would blend well with the brown. It does, of course. This is actually, I was pleasantly surprised with it, but it's kind of in a thick, it's decent. But this is the matte, matte Spanish moss, very popular with y'all on the page, you know what I'm talking about, you know. Other than that, we're just going to try and give her a rip. I got two different types of tans. I'm kind of leaning more towards this because it's a darker tan. You know, where we are at in the fall time, there's more darker colors. You know, we don't really need much greens. So it's going to be a lot of brown. Well, not too much tans either, you know. Could probably go for some brick red type situation since that's a very browny red. But I'm just really not that concerned about it. So we're getting close to having this thing being touch safe here. And then we'll get her down and we'll put the next piece up. I think I will do the stock next. And yeah, that'll be good. Let's see. Yeah, she's pretty good. Good enough to lay her down. And that's just for that base coat. Not sure if you can see, but there is kind of a little bit missing. It's going to get covered. This is just the base coat. That wasn't a problem rust area where I needed that base coat the most. So it'll be all good. Stay tuned. We'll be right back. All right. So, we will apply that same Camo Deep Forest Green to the stock. I have the recoil pad off, and I also have the cap right here. I'm going to leave those black, just for a little bit of contrast. You've seen how I did on the other rifle. I like having contrast pieces. I know everybody likes to kind of just put the whole thing together and do their thing, but those are going to get taped off, by the way. So yeah, we'll just do that. It's going on very nice on the stock, as I figured it would. And it's just going to be one little coat. Might be a little close to the joint. But it's all, like I said, it's all base coat. It's going to be fine. Happy with that. Should be good. Okay, can't really see it now. I got too much conflicting light possibly. Yeah, but you'll see it when it's, I'll put it all together once everything's dry, and then I'll do some close-ups. Oh, almost missed that spot. Like I said, this is a base coat. And then once everything's base coated, it'll all get put back together, and then we will show you in the better light how that base coat looks and what we're gonna do with it. So, yeety heety hee. See you in a couple seconds. All right, so maybe from this angle we'll get a little bit better pickadation of the color here. This thing's spitting like a motherfucker at me, Doc. I'm probably gonna, after a while, take that sling stud off, and that will become black. Or I'll just leave it. I don't know. I just need to stop being a bitch about it, probably. Alright, this piece is getting in a lot better angle here. Run. And then we'll get on this side. That's all we need from her. That's it. Hopefully you can see the color a little bit better. My big mug in the way. Oh yeah, yeah, you can definitely see the color a lot better from this angle. Sweet. So, we're going to let that hang and dry, and then I think that's pretty much all the components that's going to get a base coat. We'll be right back with it. So, as you can see, she's swinging there, and I have the receiver and trigger guard taped off, along with the top and the hammer, you know, part of the breech and everything like that. So my idea is I'm leaving the receiver black along with the scope ring, along with the scope, along with the bottom plate over here, and along with the recoil pad. So that is what that is. We're still going to get a little more cure time on this base coat before we start ripping, and I'm still trying to figure out what to do with the pattern. I have to go small because of just the surface area that we have on this. You know, it's a skinny setup, so I'm just going to have to make do with smaller patterns. I don't think I want to go digital. I don't know if that's his style. So I think I'm going to go with kind of more of like a woodland crackle with some like marshy accents. So we'll see. We're just, like I said, and if it sucks, you go over it. because it's all taped up and it's all going to be one uniform color besides the receiver, scope mount, scope, butt pad, stock cap. So there she be. Be right back. Alright, welcome back. We're going to start off with some brown stripes. And I think I found what I'm going to do. Somebody in the last video, step away from the brown. Never! Up, down, side to side. Don't matter. There we go. Like that. Like that. Like that. Like that. One last one to cap the end off there. Upwards on the other side. Cool. Good measure. More dense on that side. We'll do a couple crisscross applesauce maybe. This brown just goes on so well. Perfect. Do some going on over here. See, I'm getting carried away with that brown again, y'all. You know what? This is my shit. You have fun with it. Well, this isn't my shit. This is my buddy's gun. But he told me to do it like I do my own. So, you know, man, it'd be like that, like that, like... Oh, let me get back on this side. Good. There we go. Nope, other way. Alright. So, we'll let that chill for un momento. And I think we're gonna go. I don't know. I haven't used this one because I really don't know what's going on with it. It's kind of got like that new style Finnish crackle or Swedish or something. I don't know what to call it, but we'll give it a rip. I mean, alright. That does have some cool looking. And then I got this like kind of tree bark scale thing going on along with it. Oh, did I lose y'all? Oops. Anyways, oh, battery's dying. That's why. I put in junk batteries, so I'm going to have to swap them out. But, got some brown stripes going through. And then I kind of have possibly some other stuff going on. There's like this, might have been a little too dense, but there's this and then some of this. So I'll do some tan overlays with that or maybe some olive green. See how it looks. If not, just keep going over it. Stay tuned. Let me swap these batteries out. My camera sucks. Go on my buy me a coffee. You don't have to, but it'd be nice. Or I could just, you know, not be poor. That'd be great. So I'll try and pick it up, see if we can get a closer look here. But I went in with that one stencil and started giving it some brown. It looks better. Definitely looks better off camera, but it's kind of cool. It's kind of more rounded out than I would think, but because it's very square on the stencil, but it's more rounded out. But it'll work. I'm going to start doing some tans, hopefully. And then maybe some lighter greens. Alright, so we got more of that brown. I don't know, it's almost looking kind of like freaking dinosaur spots or something. But it's going. And now we are going to add some of this not earth brown. I just got done earthing with the brown. Here we go. Where are we at? Camo Kahiki. Camo Khaki. And we're going to do this like crackle bark stencil here. See how that goes. If not, just go over it. Well, let's see how it starts off with this guy here, if I don't bump too much into ya. Alright. Ooh, that's gonna be a run. Oh well. Some spatters. Whatever. Yeah, this is very much looking more like a straight-up, like, FUD camo, which is kind of what I was trying to go for, you know, for my buddy. So that's going to be perfect for him. God damn. Can't win for losing on them spatters. We'll dab that and blend it in. He'll never know until he watches the video. Oh, that's just Gucci enough right there. We'll go back to the brown. There. And then all good. Blend it. Do it again. Okay. Let me figure out some more there. Do get my head out of the way. Damn. This tan isn't cooperating too well. It's giving me a lot of spatter. Oh, yeah, I gotta do this side here. There we go. That's what I've been wanting. That looks a lot better. Alright. Now, we got some more of that. Let me get rid of that spatter. Spatter action rate. Oh. There. There we go. A real nice matte tan. Sorry, I kind of was doing that.
And then the stupid battery thing's running out again. I just don't get it. I just put fresh batteries in it. They're not good batteries, so that's probably what the problem is. So we're going to let that dry. We're going to go for our next layer and let this thing chill out and get to the next part of this whole thing. A little bit too tan on the barrel. That's fine. We'll cover it up with something. So we're starting to get some contrast. I know it looks might look a little heavy on the tan right now, but I reassure you, this side's actually pretty cool. Sometimes one side ends up a little bit better, like you're like, oh, effed up that side. So other than that, I think we're going to actually try a little bit of this Eden from the Rust-Oleum. It's kind of, it's not quite that bright roadie green, you know, like you would have on like a roadie brushstroke pattern. It's not that bright, so I think it could work for, you know, like early season antlerless, or, you know, it would just kind of help bring some greens, some more greens in, not so dark. So let's give that a shot real quick, and we're going to actually try that with one of my favorite stencils that was used on the last project, this one right here. So we're going to go, we're going to give one a rip up here. Hopefully, I know I'm friggin' honking huge, but let's give a spot. How about, where's the bag here? So that adds kind of some cool green. We'll try not to make that as spattery and runny. No big deal. We'll throw a dot of that. Just accenting it. You know what I'm saying? Nothing crazy. It's a bubble. Come on, don't dry like that. Oh well. Call it grit texture. So that's kind of adding some extra types of green in there. It is pretty bright, so, but it is kind of helping subdue that tan a little bit. So we won't go freaking megalomaniac crazy on it. We'll take care of this tan spot right there. There. Okay, I am going a little crazy with it. Get a small detail of it right there. Right there. Oh, that's a big glob. Oops. Oh well. Cover that up with some other part of the pattern and then it'll just blend. There. That's all we're going to probably need of that color. Now, one part I have been. Nobody will ever notice. Because I'm just that terrible. And then maybe we'll go over with some. We'll go back to maybe that green again that we started with the base coat. And we'll just kind of flash over some of these. Some of this greenness. But let's get it dry first, and then we'll go from there. So far it's a little bit different, but I think it's gonna work fine. And like I said, we'll just, you know, small layers until it gets built up into something that's got a lot of depth and is really cool. It's just kind of the way I'm doing it with these stencils. I'm having fun with it. It's pretty sweet. So when it finally gets right, I'll know. I'll have the epiphany. It'll just be that aha moment. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, we'll do a couple more shapes down here, and then on the back. I've been kind of. I don't really have the best setup for down here, as far as being able to rotate where I want. So, it's no big deal, man. We'll just deal with it. It's going to be all right. Just blend. Let her blend. I don't believe that grain was a mistake, man. That's kind of cool. Kind of helps break it up. You know what I'm saying? That's the thing about deer hunting camouflage. You just got to break it up. It doesn't matter what color it is. Just, you know, you can't be having a bunch of UV rays all over you. And you just got to make sure you're broken up. So I hear. I don't know. I have never shot a deer, so. Let's pause the camera for a minute. And let's get that layer dry a little bit longer. And then we'll figure out what we're going to go with next. Might go to... I don't, for some reason, like this army green. It's not my jam. So, just... It's kind of... For some odd reason, I just... It goes on great, though. So, it might get a couple of those. Yeah. Let's do that real quick. Why not? While we're here. Let's do that right there. Okay. It's working, actually, on this pattern. Yes. Yes. And it's helping blend out that real bright green. So I'll just take a different pattern, maybe move it sideways. Yep. Helps it along a little bit. Try not to. There we go. A little blot action there. Oh well. Same with that. That'll get covered up. That's fine. Let's try some up here. Yeah, this is going on up here pretty nice, but we're... All right, we are starting to get some wild and crazy layers going on here. Here, let's see. My flashlight. Oh, shit, it's been on the whole time. There goes that fucking battery. Yeah, I mean, it's pretty different. Some of that bright green still shines through a little bit. And then I got to go over it with just a little bit more brown to help subdue some of that tan that's coming out. And then she's going to be done. The barrel looks pretty wild. I like how the barrel turned out. It's kind of got like half of that crazy cubic unpolygonal stuff going on. Plus some other stuff. Kind of did some more there. And then, I really like that part. That part's cool up there. I like that. I don't know if I'm going to do anything with that. So, yeah. This side's looking pretty sweet. Just a couple more finishing touches. Alright, so this is what we got. Let me get out of the way of the light here. So far, I've been kind of doing some stuff off camera, sorry, but this side's a little bit more tan than I want it for him, at least. But I mean, it's freaking awesome. I mean, for me, it'd be so cool. Got some, let's see, I'll grab it by the, do it by the hanger. I've twisted, bent this hanger around so many times, it's freaking hilarious. Got some, it's just kind of more basic, really cool down there. I like that. That's still really sweet. And then, the barrel. The barrel's going to be what it's going to be. I think it looks pretty sweet. It's nice, subdued, got more browns up top. Going to need to put more browns on the other side, I think. Grab it by the receiver. But here's that other side. I like this up here. I might splash that with a little bit more brown, maybe that area. But this area has got enough good brown in it. And then I'll hit some more of these areas with some brown and some green, and then I think she's going to be all good. All right, end result. I skipped a few pieces of video, but yeah, this looks way different than I would imagine it. I had to put that Kryptek on there. Kryptek of all types. Green, tan, brown, Kryptek. It's in there. Got some there. Oops. They calling me. Got some tan right there. Got some coming through the barrel. I mean, it's another masterpiece for me. It blends nicely. I like it. See that? More Kryptek. It's just in there. Some of that crackle coming through. Some of that little stony tortoiseshell stuff coming through. I mean, it's just a little bit of everything. It's a spray paint buffet. That's kind of a cool design there. That came through kind of like some old school camo. A little bit of brown coming through there. All right. For one last time. For one last take. I'm on my GoPro, well, faux pro, which has to be plugged in into a power source because the battery's shot on that, and this thing is totally dead. I just put new batteries in it, and it will not turn on. It is toast. So, I know it's upside down. This is how I got it. I mean, pretty sweet. I'm digging it. Some of that crackle work through. Got some of that Kryptek work through. Got some of that tortoiseshell shit work through. I like it. It's just so nice. This side is kind of showing off some green a little bit. Got that brown Kryptek. Got that other stuff. Got that. It's all in there. Some Kryptek on the bottom. Got the receiver and the scope mount black. Just beauty, at least in my eyes. Well, appreciate you tuning in. And subscribe if you like what you see. I'll probably put out more shorts than I do long videos, but we got some more coming. I got some backloads. What? I got some uploads that are backlogged that I need to release that I've been editing. My software was acting really wonky the other day. Probably my computer. But we'll get it all figured out. And we'll get some content going. So yeah, subscribe if you like it. Tell your friends. Share. Comment if you hate it. I'll tell you to shut up, but it's whatever. But thanks for tuning in. I appreciate it. Y'all are the only thing, reason why I do it, I guess.